But if you are going to rest, that is one thing that you should procrastinate on. That's the one thing I want you to put off until tomorrow. Now, these could be signals that you need some time off. And those signals might be right. They could be correct. But don't take today off. Don't give in to the immediate gratification that is whispering in your ear. Shut that down. Do not listen to that little voice. Instead, go through the motions. Lift the weights. Sprint the hill. Work on the project. Get out of bed.
If you only have 24 hours in a day, your success is dependent upon how you use the 24. You gotta hear me. People talk about Oprah Winfrey, you know, Ted Turner, Warren Buffett. Listen to me. I don't care how much money you make. You only get 24 hours in a day. And the difference between Oprah and the person that's broke is Oprah uses her 24 hours wisely. That's it. Listen to me. That's it. You get 24. I don't care if you broke, you grew up broke. I don't care if you grew up rich. I don't care if you're in college, you're not in college. You only get 24 hours. And I blew up literally. I went from being a high school dropout to selling 6,000 books in less than 6 months. What happened? My 24 hours. I was like, okay, Eric, you got to get a grip on your 24 hours because you're about to be broke for the rest of your life. And that's all I need you to do for me. I can tell you all about your life if you just write down your 24-hour schedule for me and you let me look at it. I can tell you where you're going to be in 5 years. I can tell you where you're going to be in 10 years. I can tell you where you're going to be in 20 years if you keep that schedule.
And that they're, and that they can't get those things. So that's kind of interesting, right? And it's always kind of a shocker to have the myth of that person burst. But see, here's the thing. Although we're not cut from a different cloth, the fact that I mastered consistency is the difference. And most people will never do that. No one wants you to succeed, right? Only your mom. And even your mom doesn't want you to succeed because she's afraid you're not going to call her back. Your brain doesn't want you to be a big success. Your brain just wants to keep you alive. All your brain wants you to do is just pump out one or two kids so the DNA can continue on. That's it. Your brain will trick you. You are your own worst enemy. I know that if I fail to do that, that I am not instilling those habits that's gonna have a big picture, long-term goal. Dudes, talent is overrated, homie. There's no price too great for me. There's nothing too great. I would die for my dreams. You know what I'm saying? I'm willing to risk it. There's nothing too great. There's no amount that I'm not willing to go. You can accomplish anything you want, man, if you're willing to do it, right? But again, you'll realize that what you think you are is not what you are. You become something else. You literally become something else. If you want to be someone who's tireless, you cannot be tired down. You'll become something else. So you don't have those limitations a normal human being has. You don't have that because you become something else. You become something that embodies certain things that you're trying to move forward. You'll go to any length. So you're not gonna get tired, because at that point you have God on your side. That's not even you anymore, dude. Big. It's like, you know how? What I do is I focus on maybe one or two or three things at a time, and then I just do it. Thank you. you.